Morning, everyone. I am Pankaj Bhageria. I work at Sumeru Software Solutions as a lead. So I work basically with open source technologies like Rails, JavaScript, Node.js. I started my career with PHP, moved to .NET, then I worked for 5 years with Rails. And now for last 1 year, I am working with JavaScript. Am I audible? Yes. Okay. So I'd like to know more about you guys, like how many of us are fully developing applications in JavaScript from end to end, full stack applications, Node.js, client side? Can I have some hands up? Okay. So you guys are aware about express.js. Okay. And how many of us are not aware about Node? Like we'll be using Node for the first time. We have just read something about it. Okay. So we'll start with some basics of JavaScript. It will be a complete hands-on session. I'll be showing some code, you will be writing that code. And we have few volunteers with us. Robin, Munesh, Ashutosh, and Divakar at the end. So they'll be helping you out with the code if you get stuck at any point. So please be free to call them. So we'll start with some basics of JavaScript. So let's open the Firebug console. Okay, so functions, I'll give you some information about functions in JavaScript. So functions in JavaScript are first class citizens, as in they can be assigned to variables and they can be passed to functions as arguments. So let us see some examples of that. So the way we define function in JavaScript is, problem with the console. Okay, I'll use Chrome. Okay. Zoom. So let's say we define a function x. It's not a multi-line thing. So this is the way we call the function. So x is a variable which stores the function. Now this x can be passed to another function as an argument. So let's say we create another function y. So y is a function which accepts function as an argument. So y can be some function, like in practice it can be something like logger, a logger which is logging some data. So we call the function y with x. So high is printed. So now there is a difference in this and this syntax. See, when you pass x to y, then it is passing the function. But when you do this, it is passing the return value of the function. Okay. So we have seen, okay. Now we'll see something called anonymous function. So instead of passing x to y, we can define a function here itself. So this is called an anonymous function. Okay. So in JavaScript, in the code we'll be writing, we'll be using a lot of anonymous function. So these are used when, you don't need to use this function anymore. Like only this place you are going to use it. You're not going to reuse it any other place. Then you don't need to define it separately. So a lot of event handlers are passed like this. So if this event takes place, then call this function. So we'll see more about it later. So we'll move to objects now. So objects in JavaScript are just key value pairs. So creating a new object is very simple. Let's say we create a user object. So you can add properties to the object, or if you want to create an object with some properties. All right. So now you can access this properties via either this way, like directly dot syntax, or you can pass a string. So we created an object directly. Now we create a class, we create a function to create this object. So it's a simple function, user creator. It returns an object. So now user create is a function which is returning an object, which is user. So u equal to user creating is acting similar to a class. It is playing the role of a class. So we could have defined the function with some parameters. So we have created a function which is playing the role of a class. So in JavaScript, classes are nothing but functions. So an object can be extended anytime. Like you suppose you want to add a method to a property to this thing, to this object. So you can do u.gender equal to male. So this property has been added. So extending objects in JavaScript is very simple. You just need to use this syntax, the dot operator, and assign that value. So that property gets added. Now this property could also be a function. So now u.ages undefined currently, okay. I've not defined the age. So let's define the age. u.age equal to 28. So is senior returns false. So if we keep it as 70, senior will return 2. So object is a collection of properties which can be either some values or functions. So we have seen how to extend an object, how to create an object. Okay, public and private properties of an object. So we'll go back to the function user creator. So the properties which are returned here, the name property, will all be public properties. So if we define any variables inside this function which we do not return, those will be private properties. You'll understand this private public concept more with the examples when we start building the Express framework. So any doubts till now? Anybody? All okay? So today in this workshop, what we are going to do, so today we'll cover the basics of JavaScript, which we have done to some extent. Then we'll see what are the advantages of using Node.js and why is it so popular today. Then we will go on to building our own Express.js framework. So people who don't know they have never used Express.js, they will also be able to do it, because it is like we'll be just building the basic features. It is a good way to learn Express.js. Like generally when people learn Express.js, they do not understand the internals. So here you'll exactly understand what is happening inside. So like when you start using it, you will be in a good place to hack it and extend it. Okay. So can I have some answers from the audience? Like what do you know about Node? Why is it so popular? Anybody? Non-blocking IO. Non-blocking IO, Google V8 engine, anything else? Yeah. So Node is JavaScript on the server side. So till today, like when we started programming, most of us, we thought of JavaScript as a client-side programming language. It was just used in the beginning, it was just used for some form validations. Then we started using it for some animations, some date picker steps from jQuery plugins. And today we use it for full single page applications, like entire applications are built in JavaScript. So, and then Node allows us to build the server side also in JavaScript. So the one good thing about Node is like one language and everything you can do. If you know JavaScript, you can build server side and client side. So JavaScript is everywhere today. If you know JavaScript, you can build server side, you can build for mobile, you can build for web. So, and you cannot escape JavaScript. Even if you don't build your server side in Node, if you use Ruby on Rails or PHP or .NET or something Java, you have to learn JavaScript because browsers today only support JavaScript. They don't support any other language. So that is the reason, that is one of the reasons. Second reason is non-blocking IO. So to understand this, we'll look at some code. So we know Ruby. How many of us know Ruby? Okay. Anyways, not much Ruby is needed to understand this. So here we are creating a new object of user. This params is coming from the client side. The second line saves the object. So what it will do, it will send the data to the database and wait for the database to respond. So until the database saves the data and responds, the Ruby process will keep waiting. And so the third line is not executed until the time this is completed. So what is the disadvantage in this? Like, the Ruby process is doing nothing, it is just waiting. So if our database server is somewhere external, so this is just one example of IO. So IO can be on a network. You want to fetch some data from some other server, you want to fetch some data from the file system. So wherever IO is involved, most of the languages, Ruby, Java, and they will all will wait. They don't do anything at that time. So that is a waste of time. Waste of time is waste of resources. And how does Node do it? It does not wait. It will continue doing other tasks. So what the save function does here is it accepts a callback. So earlier we studied the anonymous function thing. This is that. So this is a callback which will be called when database gives the response. So this line will be executed and then console.log hi will be executed. So this line is executed before this line. So what happens is the Node process can keep serving other requests. It will not wait for that request to get completed. So this improves the performance a lot. This adds to performance. So we'll take an analogy of the non-blocking IO, how a waiter works in a restaurant. So he takes an order from the table, he goes to the cook, he tells him the order, and he goes back to for another order. So he does not wait for the cook to complete his cooking and preparation of the dish. So however, traditionally how other languages work are they wait. So if the dish is taking 10 minutes to cook, whether he waits or not, the order will be delivered in 10 minutes only. So there is no use waiting. It is better he goes and collects other orders. So basically this is how Node works in a non-blocking fashion. Okay, what is express.js? Yeah.
Comes to a Ruby on Rails server, is a new process formed? No, it works in a, it, it,
Yeah, but the that mechanism is a lot of memory heavy. It consumes a lot of memory. So this is single thread. If there are multiple processes, you can start multiple workers of Node. So it is very Node is very good to take advantage of multiple processes. I think it is not out of the box. Like, so, like, I think the one of the other reasons is the libraries which are available in Node are all async. Async programming is not like sync programming is little easier to do. Async is a different thinking pattern, so it will be initially it will be like a difficult to change. It's not that difficult, but there are solutions available to that, like promises, which makes it easier. Like, it's difficult to think that this line will be executed after this line, like before this line. Generally we think serially, okay, whichever line comes first will be executed before that. And this is a very simple example. When there are multiple blocks of code and there are multiple callbacks, then it becomes more complex. Okay, so Express is a web framework for Node. Currently it is the de facto for Node for building all the web applications. There are many, Express is a very basic stuff. It has a lot of extensions to it. Extensions in terms of frameworks and plugins both. There are many frameworks which are available on top of Express, and there are many plugins you can plug into Express to extend the features. So we start by building a very simple HTTP server. So let's have our editors open. We'll create a new JS file, server.js. Okay, before that, you can clone this Git repository. This has all the code we'll do in today's workshop. So, like, there are 7 milestones we will be achieving. So, if any time you get stuck on any of the steps, you can move forward from that directory. And of course, our volunteers are there. And if you complete your stuff, then you can help out other people around you. So Node has a concept of modules. Modules is like gem in Ruby. It's basically a reusable library. So there is a module called HTTP, which lets you build networking applications on Node. So we will use that to build our Express framework. So it is by default provided by Node, so you don't need to install it. So we have created an HTTP module, required it. Now HTTP has a method called create server. So this creates a server for us. Then it accepts a function which will be called on every request. So this is basically a callback. Whenever a request occurs, this function will be called. So it will accept two arguments, a request variable and a response variable. This is good. So we have created a server. Now we need to send a response back. So there are various methods available on the response object which allow you to set headers and write the success code and finally send the message. Like end will end the response and send some message back. Var message equal to hello. So now we need to start the server. So there is a listen method which accepts a port number. We have created a server which responds to any request with a message hello HTTP. We didn't start the server. We start the server by the command node space file name. So this was our first milestone, creating a simple server. So once everybody has reached this, like completed this, we'll move on to the second. You can check whether anybody needs anybody. Okay. So you can skip these three lines in case if it is taking too long to type. This is not compulsory, like it's so code will still work, but it's a good practice to send the headers. ask if anybody needs help. Yeah, yeah. If you have already started the server and you are making some changes to the code, please control C and restart the server. Everybody is having node.js installed, right? Anybody not? You can probably pair up with someone. It's running.
It shouldn't display some command.
No, it does not. We have not written anything.
But if you open local host, it doesn't, right?
That's fine.
Yeah. So we'll move to the second step. Anybody still waiting, like doing writing this code? So we'll create a new file, my express.js. And we copy paste the code of server.js into my express.js. Okay, attention here please. So now we'll be creating a module out of this. Font size. So we create a function, myExpress. And we do module.exports equal to myExpress. So what module.myExports does is, like, whenever you require the file myExpress.js, so module.exports define what will be required. So if we export myExpress function and we do where myExpress equal to require, we give the path of the file myExpress. So this variable will hold what is exported. Okay, so we shift this server thing inside myExpress. To start the server, we need a method called listen. So our myExpress module should return an object which has a method listen. So we return we need to define this function now. So our listen function is just a wrapper method. It just takes the message and passes on to the server object. So what we do here is, so we are calling this myExpress function. The myExpress function is returning an object which has a listen method. And to start the server, we call the listen method on it. So I was talking about the private and public thing. So server here is a kind of private variable. So we don't have access to server from app. But the listen method, it has access to server. Because the server variable is in the scope of this method. So this is a concept of closure. Like the variables which are in the scope of the function, when the function is passed from anywhere else, those variables will be accessible to the function. So this is a very core concept to JavaScript. So any doubts in this till now? All clear? Nobody is responding. You can do a thumbs up when you have finished coding, so that I know that you are writing something. So how many are still doing, like working? You can also check out the code from this GitHub repository. You can see the code from there. It is problem seeing on the screen. Listen method, you can add a console.log that that it has started. This is my express server. Okay. So when you require a module, so this is a module which is available with Node. Like Node is default providing it by default. So this is right now not converted to a module. So by default, the node will search for node modules in a directory called node underscore modules. Inside the folder, then it will go to the parent folder. Inside that, it will search for a directory node modules. Inside that, it will search for that module. That is one way of requiring if you don't specify the path. Otherwise, you can specify the path of the file. So dot is current directory, and inside that, my express. We'll do that today at the end of this. Okay. Anybody still doing? Robin? Red one. So another 3 minutes and we will start with the third module. Instead of HTTP, my express. Yeah, little bit more on that. Okay, so the place where listen is called here the in this scope, the variable server is not accessible. right? But where listen is defined in this scope, inside the function, server is accessible. So even if when the scope has finished, like when it is outside that scope, those variables will be accessible to the function. Those will not be like collected by the garbage collector. So those variables will continue to exist in the memory. So we'll move on to the third step. So right now our Express framework is returning the same request for every response, same response for every request. So whatever you give it, we get the same response. So this is because we are not checking what is the request object. So now we will add routing to it. So routing is a mechanism where we check the request URL and we give different responses for depending upon the URL. So we create one more file called routes.js. Here we create a function called routes. And we export this method. So we'll define a method get, which will accept two parameters. One is the path and one is the handler. So basically we define different handlers for different path. Currently what we are doing, this is the single handler for all the requests. So we'll define a method get which will define different handlers for different paths. So we will use an object to store the path and the handlers. The key of the object would store the path and the value of the key would be the handler itself. So we initialize it to be an empty object, and whenever get is called, then key of the routes table is path equal to handler. So we want to use the get method. So we return an object which has a get method. So now in module.exports, we have exported the function routes, but actually we don't need the function, we need this object. So we'll call this function here. So what gets exported is this object. Okay. Then back to express.js. We include routes. So we need to pass on the get method to the myExpress object. So we export it here. So now routes is not a function, it is a object. We could have written the same thing in server.js, but it is good to write the routing functionality separately, like so that. My express.js. Okay, here. Yeah, you could have done it, but like this is, I felt it is more convenient. Like, I don't want to create object of routes here because it will be created only one time, right? It will not be created again and again. Anyways, you can do both ways. I'm not sure. I have seen when exports can be anything, like it need not be only a function. It can be different things. So it depends upon what you want to use your, like why have you created the module for. Okay. So now back to server.js. We define app.get. In a morning method, so the handler's arguments will be request and response. And we go back to my express, we copy this, cut this actually. We have defined a route, so this get method goes here and it makes an entry in the routes table, but now we want to match the route also, so we define a match method. So match method should accept an argument request from where it can take out the URL. So it takes the routes table and passes the key as the path of the request, and in the myExpress the server callback we find what is the handler equal to routes.match request. So we find the handler through routes.match. If handler exists, we call that handler, otherwise we return routes not found. Okay, get is not called get of undefined. Server.js. We have defined the method before creating the object. Okay, one more thing we forgot was, we forgot to export the match method. So So we have not defined the this path, we have defined morning. Okay, here we have to pass the parameter to the handler. Request comma response. So we can define one more route in server.js. So there are three different files now which you have to write code in. So you cannot display three simultaneously, so you can refer the GitHub repository if you want to refer to the code. So anybody has any doubts? Yeah, this is very basic stuff. Like, we don't, obviously there will be a separate routes file as we proceed. Like, today we are not going to build an extensive web framework. This is like, so Express has a similar interface. I will say same interface. So the purpose of this building this framework is not to build a production ready framework. It is just to understand few concepts. Yeah, it will be a separate routes file. server.js file. It is night only, I think. And open two console windows. I think that is a problem in routes this time, I guess. Working? Okay, any? Can I help?
I compared it with your GitHub code also, I'm getting, still getting this error, I don't get. Get over it. I'm doing.
Show this one. Wait, here. Routes.get. Okay, go here. Routes. Where get? Get. Here, call the function. It is a function call. Because we have to return the object, no?
Okay.
We don't have to return the function, we have to return the object. So here, get is wired to routes.get.
So basically, we are trying to return a function, a return variable.
We are returning an object. So this here, my express is returned.
Okay.
And we call this function in server.js.
Yeah, I understood that.
So that returns an object which has a get method.
Okay.
And that get method is from here.
Okay. So when you say var get equal to function of path comma handle. And a particular this thing, under path, it is trying to return get as an object and match as an object.
It is an entire object. Get is a key with the get method as a function value. Match is a key with the match method as a function value. So this is key value pairs. This is the entire object.
Okay, so that means here also it's the same, right?
Yeah.
Listen, the anything that is with listen is a keyword and listen as an object.
Yeah.
So this listen comes from, you are trying to say,
this listen is here only.
Yeah, from here. Right. And get is from outside.
Cut the link, now we are on off 3 minutes. Object has no method get. Go there. Routes file. Go here. Routes dot get. Where is there console?
Console.
Server.js 6. You restarted the server?
Yeah, I stopped the server and started. Should I want to check whether the server is shut down properly?
1 minute, it will be shut down. Go here. Dot get. Go here. Function.
Okay, maybe the same problem. App, okay.
Routes, put the routes.
Any friendly errors?
Now try once. Do an LS once. Node server. Node server.js.
So this routes table, right? This is getting properly. You are telling that it's having a path and a handler. Because when
correct.
You have five routes and you have five routes and handler. Now, when you execute this, what happens exactly? Will it take
is the path, this is the handler.
Yeah,
it goes to the route table, it stores this
so
is the key,
exactly,
and this is the
that is happening
here. See, wait. Here we are exporting this method, right?
Yeah.
We are returning this object. This is getting, when this function is called, this object is getting created. And
yeah,
here,
that is getting created,
so
get
exactly method, get method, we put route.get.
Yeah, route.get will
and
call this one.
Mm.
Here you will, okay, you will add all those.
Mm.
Route,
yeah,
go and
yeah.
Add it and based on that it will match whether it is present or not.
Yeah.
If present, then
it will
the match thing.
So it will send
the
corresponding
handler.
Yeah. Otherwise it will send. So it is like an, if the key is present, it will return the handler, otherwise it will return nothing. So anybody? So anybody still doing? So we'll move to the next step. So next step is very simple. So you might have observed we are writing a lot of repetitive code here. So let us extend the response object. We'll add a send method to it. So create a file, response.js. Here we will again create a function response. Module.exports. Response. So what we have to do is, so we need to extend the response object. The response object is not having a method which will send the headers automatically. So we are having to, we need to send the, like for one response we need to write 4 lines of code, which is quite repetitive. So we create a send method. Okay, so we have to extend the response object, so we expect the argument as response. Then we just add the send method to the response object. Response.send equal to function. We'll accept a message here. So this function is not returning anything. We are just, we'll pass the original response object and it will modify the that object. We don't need any return value from this function. So immediately after the handler is called, we'll call this function with the response object. So now we can replace this. The send. So if we check the network tab, like what the content headers, then we see that we are getting the content length and the content type headers. So let us only use END instead of send. So here we are not getting the content type and the content length headers. So similarly, we can add other methods to this, like we can add a method to send a JSON response. So we parse this object JSON. So we are assuming this object is a JSON object. So let's call it JSON object. So here message equal to json.stringify. And then we can copy this. So the content type will be its application JSON, right? Just let me confirm. Okay, so we'll see this existing file. So similarly, we can write a response or redirect method. So when we redirect to some other URL, the response code is 301 and important header is the location where we need to redirect. So we use this function. Now in the server.js, we'll add few routes. app.get go to night function request response response.redirect, we'll go to the night URL. write one more to return a JSON object. JSON underscore morning. Restart the server. So first we'll check the go to night method. Go to night. So it has redirected to night. Let's check the the first call response is the response code is 301. You cannot see that. 301 move permanently, and the second call goes to the night method. Summarize this. So we created a response file. We created a response file with a response function. It accepts the response object as an argument and it adds several functions to it, send, JSON, and redirect. In the myexpress.js, just after our create server handler is called, we extend that object via the function call. So you all can start implementing this. The repository.
Internet, which is
MSN.
to the next part, I think. Okay, that is then my mistake. We have not used it. We will use it in the next step.
What is the significance of using .js versus both are same?
Both are same. .js is default. In the code. Little bit like we'll cover in the seventh part, we'll actually use express middleware.
Yeah, express middleware is what I was talking about.
So we will, the middleware implementation will be ours, but the middleware will use from express. Are you sure you're in the right file?
Yeah.
In many files, no?
Good.
1 minute. You have to call this function here because you want to return this object. We'll come to it. Seventh part will clear that.
So we'll be dealing with you know, dynamic parameters like call and ID part.
Next part is that.
We are exporting routes with parentheses. What's the difference between?
So here we want to export this object.
Okay.
We don't want to export the method, the function.
Okay.
That's why we call it here, so that this is.
Only
you could have, what you could have done is you could have called it where routes object equal to routes, and you could have exported that. This extends this object. This. So whatever methods are there in the response function, go to the response file. So we are adding send method, JSON method, redirect method to the response object. Yeah, so we are extending that object. Return responses. See, what we are doing is we are adding third. In other things, you might have seen we were defining those variables there.
They're actually passing that object.
We are extending that object. With the, on that object, we are adding the methods.
That doesn't need that return on.
This is not required.
It's
Return. That was by mistake, I think. If you do suppose res equal to response of res, then that would be useful. So right now if you don't put this will return nothing.
Yeah, but it will actually modify the object itself.
Correct. But some people might do that. They might assign x equal to response of x. So that is just a convenience method. Suppose if someone does s equal to res of x, look the my express.js.
Okay.
If someone does res equal to response of this, then
okay.
It just a convenience method that it returns that object. It's not required for the current syntax. Anyone still needs time? We can proceed. So now we'll pass some parameters through the query. So like we'll pass name equal to something like this. So we go ahead and add a request.js file. So what we are doing here is, here again we are extending the request object. So we are adding a object of params to it. So we have used here two libraries, URL and query string. So we use URL to parse our URL. So the URL will be of the format like good morning. Name equal to Pankaj. So from this we need to extract this much. So for that we use url.parse and then .query returns a string which has this content. And after that there is a library called query string. So query string, if you pass a string to it, it will create an object out of it. So what qs.parse will return is, it will return something like this, name Pankaj. So we go to my express.js, include this. Request. extend the request object. And we add a few routes. There has been an object called params added on request object, so we can access that. Params of name. Okay, so the module QS is not natively provided by Node, so we can install that by using a command called npm install package name, that is QS. Now you see a node modules folder has been created in your workshops folder. This is our base folder. Inside this, this QS module has been installed. So the route is not matching because the match function is just passing request.url. So the URL contains the query string also. So URL is currently this one. But what we have defined in the server.js is this one. So it will not match. So let us modify the routes.js. Again we include URL, library URL. And pass URL.parse. So this time we need the path. So there is a property called path name, which will return the path of that URL. So now it should work. So we are able to extract parameters from the query string. So the parse method of the query string library will also, like if you pass an object user of name, and user of last name, if we want to pass parameters like this, this will work. So we can start implementing this. So we create a file called request.js. URL.parse will take in the entire URL and you can extract from it the query string the into the object. So this part is created by URL.parse and from this to this is done by QS.parse. URL has a URL library has a parse method to convert this to this, but it does not work for embedded objects like user of just now we did right, user of first name, user of last name. That will not work in the URL.parse. Built-in query string module is there?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. I think yeah, that too was the difference. I got confused. The URL, the built-in query string module, it did not parse the entire embedded objects. This is the thing which is used in Express only. QS. Installed. Query string may not be installed. This has to be installed. QS. it's by visual MIDI only. This will export the function itself.
Okay.
This will export. See, it is something similar to where x is equal to quest. The return value of the object function is returned.
In this case, the complete function itself is returned.
This one is from the repository you have written.
Yeah, from the data wire.
Okay. This is working?
No, that one, if you just go for morning and display, but that parameter is not working, so it will be fine.
Pass the parameter, then it will not work. You have not done that, no? Go to routes.js. So here you have to pass url dot parse.
But that part we have done in request, request.js.
And here also, while matching, you need to remove the query string, no? Matching only the path name is used. restart.
Is the correct file. Close all other files which are not part of this project. You have multiple projects here. Express request response route sample. Go to route. My express path handler. Should match. Routes dot match. Go to routes. It's route not found, so this is not of concern. This is working. Routes not found is before only.
It's getting that value undefined. It's not fetching the value from that.
Mm-hmm.
And you're parsing it.
Mm. You can put some console.log over here. In the routes. The match thing. Console.log this one, route handlers, console log this both, this and this statement.
That is not JSON file, but the only value is
we didn't create it now.
Manually
I'll show you one more.
So you do npm install okay. Install QS, yes, you can do save. Okay. So now
I'm totally blank about not
okay. So now package.json should be created. The package.json is not created, no? It was
maybe because it was already installed QS, I just installed it.
Do npm init. You can add your dependencies. Dependencies is there in this QS.
Okay.
Now you can add here, do npm install. JSON, show the code. You're not doing end, I think. Server.js.
Yeah,
no, server.js. The routes where you defined. Morning. Just.json. Inside JSON. You can say it. shouldn't. Actually, you do this here because message.length is calculated. That should not be an issue. But the length I think was a problem, so it was maybe waiting for more.
Right. So this is object here. So you're checking for the length of
object. The object of length of object, length of string is different. So now we'll move on to adding some more functionality to routes. So right now our routes are very static routes. They will only accept like it is exact matching of routes. We cannot pass parameters inside the URL. Something similar to like we cannot pass morning slash name. This we cannot pass right now. So we want to define routes which are something like this: morning slash colon name. So name is a variable, it will match. So whenever a colon is there, that becomes a variable name and it will match anything that is there, and we should get this variable inside params. Something like this we should be able to do. So the code for this is a little complex. So if you see the routes file inside the sixth part, so I'll explain you this. So the upper one is the route we have defined, and the lower one is the path which we are getting from the request. So what we do is we split both of them into an array. So and after that we loop through the array and match. So at any point of time, if there is no match, then the route is not matching. But if there is a colon, if the route parameter, the route entry has a colon here. So if there is a colon here, we don't match at that time. We just take this and put it into the params object, and we put this as a value. So we'll see the code. Okay, the first difference now is that the route array, wait, not visible. Now the route handler, the route table is no longer a object because it is no longer exact matching. So we cannot use objects. So we have created an array, and the get method pushes into the array the path and the handler. So when a match is fired, we loop through the route handlers. Like route handler is currently an array, so we loop through this array
and check if the current entry is matching the path. If it is matching, we stop there and return the handler. We return the handler and the params from that path. So the first, there may be multiple routes which may be matching the path, but the first route will be executed. So here we create two arrays. We initialize that match, we assume that matching is true, and we initialize an empty object of URL parameters. Then we route through the route array. So first we check if the first character of the entry is a colon. If it is a colon, we don't match it, we just put it into the URL params by removing the colon. If it is a star, again we don't match it, we just, so if there is a star in the routes, then it does not need to be matched further. All the further, like till now, if it has been matched, it will return true. And finally, if it is not either of these two cases, then we will compare both the values, route and the path. And if they do not match, we will return a false. So there is a slight change in the express also. So instead of the handler, now we get a match. So match either is an object which consists of so if the match is found, then params and handler is written. If match is not found, then false is written. So in the my express code, we modify it similarly, like we if a match is found, we add the params and we execute the handler. If a match is not found, we return route not found. Yeah, so this code you may like to copy from the folder directly. It's little longer. So you can basically replace the routes file itself from the directory 6-more routes and then modify the my express file.
वॉशरूम जाके तो संभाल अंदर।
हाँ ओके ऐसा बोल रहा है।